Yes, students. So now we are going to, start writing a letter on a formal topic. And the topic is like you want to join a dance academy, but you don't know the, details. You don't know like what, how can you get admission? What would be the charges or what would be the other, requirements to take admission in that particular academy. So you want to know the details. So you will write a letter to the dance academy's manager seeking the inquiry or asking the details. So this kind of letter where we want to know something, this kind of letter comes in the category of formal letter. But yes, formal letter, because you're going to write a letter to some formal institute, right? So it will be a letter of inquiry. Okay, letter of inquiry related to here in this particular question, you want to take admission. So before that, you want to know certain details. So here in this kind of letter, all of you listen to me. In this kind of letter, one thing you should know very carefully that when you want to know the details, you have not Is that clear? Okay. Is that clear? You have not taken admission. You have not 100% decided to take admission, and you are not bound to take admission. Okay. You want to know the details, and when that academy will send you the answer, when they will send you the reply, only then you will decide whether you want to go there or not. Is that clear? So here you are free to ask anything. But yes, the relevant questions. Somebody is speaking. All of you sit straight. Forget that somebody else is sitting with you, your friend or the others. Sit very straight and be attentive. Okay. Main thing is that when we want to buy something, we always ask certain questions. Isn't it? Even when you want to buy buy some pen for yourself, a simple pen, even then you ask so many questions. Isn't it? Then when you are going to take admission in some academy, then you will, of course, ask many questions. So first of all, make out, try to think, what would you like to know if you want to take admission somewhere? What will come to your mind? What will make you decide that, yes, I will take admission in this place? What will be the deciding factor? Okay, fees. If somebody says, okay, free of cost, but there is very poor, faculty, no infrastructure, then what will you do there? Will you go there? So only fees, not the criteria. Many a times we are ready to buy something when it is, good for us. Then we say quality is there. If you want something, then you have to give something. That is there. So only fee is not the always criteria. But yes, reasonable fee is also there, should be there. So okay, fee. She said fee, okay. What else? Timings, very important. And timings should be as per your schedule. Because the 9th standard student, I said, so for a student, school is very important. And okay, so timing, will that time suit you what they tell you? Okay, you'll be asking the time slot. Okay, you'll be asking what would be that batch time for which timings they have, and then later on you'll decide yes, this will suit me. Okay, fee, timings, what else? Okay, let me write side by side.
Infrastructure.
That is better. What is infrastructure? The kind of facilities they have. The kind of room or the, the hall, the music systems. Okay, the kind of, location is different, but first let us discuss infrastructure. Okay, the kind of things they have inside. Okay, do they, will they provide you enough things, enough requirements? Okay, I'm coming to that one by one. Okay, so infrastructure, then location also matters. Yes. Like maybe you go there by car. Maybe there is no scope for you to park your car there. You know, maybe there is no scope for you to take your take a turn for your car. Yeah. Okay. But sometimes, you know the location, but even then you can ask these things inside if you want to know. Okay, parking facility. Yes, you can ask. Does the location allow, does the location have proper parking facilities and all? You can ask if you, otherwise you can skip. Okay. This is, you can say optional. Okay. What else? Faculty. I guess this is most important. What kind of dance instructor they have got? Faculty. Do they have got, untrained faculty or are they trained ones? Okay, are there some awardees? Okay. Till what level have they been able to get something? Okay, have they got some achievement? Anche, what else? Transport facilities, I guess Transac at least don't give. Security. Okay. Will you be safe there? Yes. Security. Yes, security, yes. I never thought about this, but good. Yes, what else? Dance. Okay, faculty and the kinds of dances they'll teach you. Okay. Kinds of dances, that's it. Spelling? Variety. Okay, what rating they have got, you mean? Okay, if you want to know the rating of a place, then you can't ask them. That you can search. You know, rating is given by the reviewers. Okay, what else? That's it. If these things are okay, then will you go there? That will be like a clear. Okay, address will be there. Okay. What else? So when these things are there, you will say, okay, let me take admission there. Fine. Environment of the, like what kind of environment do you mean? Maybe she wants to say like, if they follow all the COVID protocols. You know, you can ask nowadays, like what COVID protocols, do they follow the COVID protocols yet? You know? COVID protocols, when you will ask, all the things would come, sanitization, vaccination, and all, social distancing and all. Okay. You can also ask number of students per batch. That also you can ask. Right. And finally, of course, which you told me in the very beginning, fee. How much fee? Any concession for the deserving students? Any scope for competition? Will there be competitions? Yes. That is very important. And if you're going to learn seriously, then you would need to know whether they will be giving you some scope to grow also or not. Okay, so write down these points. Will there be a scope for competitions? Do they follow COVID protocols? Then what else? Fee. How much fee do they charge? And will there be any discount for the deserving candidates? Or will there be scholarships? Okay. Done? Okay, now write the letter. Will you be able to write? Okay, format. What is format for a letter? Okay, format now. Don't keep dusters here. All chalks are there. Okay, format wise, whenever we write a formal letter, we always write our self-address on the top. Today, you people are talking a lot. So Diwali flavor is not yet over? Huh? Diwali is over? Now we'll wait for the next Diwali. Okay, now become quiet. Yes. So formal letter on the very top, self-address. Self-address also means address of the addressee, your address, sender's address. Okay. So sender's address includes the house number and the city. Okay, if you're writing from Ludhiana, then it will be 55 Safdarganj, Ludhiana. Imagine, I mean, okay, so you are from Ludhiana, did I tell you this?
Yes.
So don't forget that. So after the self-address, you can leave a line, then what will come? Date. Right date. Immediately after this format, I'll be checking some students' notebooks. Okay, and those notebooks will be displayed here online. So immediately after the format is over. Okay, self-address, then date, then what? Receiver's address. So who is the receiver here? Who said Dance Academy? Okay, never mind. Quayesh will tell us. Who is the receiver here, beta? Whom are we writing this letter? No one will tell him. Hands down. Who is receiving the letter? Stand up. No one. Yes. Do you know a lot? Stand up. Who is going to receive this letter? Yes. Very good. Silent clap for him. Not because he gave the answer because somebody else told him, but because he was thinking now. Thinking is more important than telling the correct answer also. The moment you start thinking, your progress starts happening. Is that clear? And thinking will happen only when you are quiet. Okay, receiver's address will mean the manager. Dance Academy. Did you name your academy? Have you given your Dance Academy a name? You should. I did not tell you in the question Dance Academy, but you can give some name to it. Okay. So what name have you given? ABCD Dance Academy. Very nice. Okay, Dance India Dance. That's an academy's name. Okay, so whatever, you can give your name to the academy. The manager, Deepak Dance Academy, Safdarganj Road, Ludhiana. Then after this receiver's address, leave a line after this. Yes, then subject. You can write salutation also first, and you can write subject also first. What will be the subject, Kirtima? Absent? Yes. Okay. No. Yes. Anyone else? Wants to know. Yes. Inquiry. We don't start a subject. We don't start any sentence with a verb like wants to know or to know or to inquire or neither like inquiring. So you can start it with a noun, inquiry, I-N-Q-U-I-R-Y. Okay, inquiry about admission or the process of admission, whatever. The main thing is the word inquiry should be there. Don't say inquiring. After the subject, what will you put? Salutation. You can say, dear manager. Yes, after subject, leave line. What's the purpose of leaving line? Cleanliness or clarity? Okay. Huh? Yes, that's the correct answer. See, if I say informally, the purpose of leaving line after one thing or the other is to bring clarity, to show that things are distinct. But the main thing is the segments get separated. Okay, receiver's address separated. Date separate, subject different, then salutation. Then after salutation, should we leave a line? No, because that is where we have started talking to the person. After dear manager, we'll start talking about the letter. So what's the purpose of writing letter? So after this dear manager.
Dear manager, line.
No, after dear manager, don't leave any line. So after the salutation, my goodness, who is asking so many questions? Though asking questions is a very, very good habit, but I have told you, like each time we leave a line, that is only to separate the various segments. So when one segment is over, leave line. Okay, never mind. If you ask question, I would rather congratulate you. Because when you ask question, you are thinking. Anji Kirtima, why are you laughing under your mask? Okay. Okay, now we are going to Quayers. Yes, what happened? Mask up. Mask up. Yes. Okay, now content-wise. Format. First of all, we would mention, we'll give the reference. What is reference? Like from where we, from where we got to know about this academy. Maybe we got to know about this academy through our friend, the one who already goes there. Maybe we got to know about it through some Facebook page. Or what? Or Insta page, okay? Or Twitter, okay? Or in the newspaper? Newspaper you people never open, so you cannot write. Okay? Okay, somebody, the one who goes there, that person dances very well. So you got impressed and you want to go there. Okay? So any reference you can give. He is asking me, ma'am, reference is important or not. You tell. It is? Okay. After the reference, you will mention the purpose of writing. You introduce yourself. Immediately after I've written the points, I'll call some child to come here and tell us the whole letter orally. Those who are speaking so much orally. Where's the mask? Is there any mask in charge in the class? Where is your mask? Okay, reference. Introduce yourself, I mean. Just brief. I'm a student of 9th standard in a renowned school in Ludhiana. Your name must not be told here. You don't need to tell who you exactly are. Just say, I'm a student of 9th standard in a renowned public school of Ludhiana. Why are you so intelligent? Did you tell in the address that you are a student? Did you tell in the address that you are a student of that particular school? Okay. Okay. Introduce yourself very briefly. Here, introduction means just a designation. If you're a businessman, you can mention, I'm a businessman of a renowned company in Ludhiana. Businessman also learn dance, you know, whatever. I'm an IAS officer and I've suddenly developed a hobby to learn dance. So introduce yourself briefly. After this, what will you say? You will talk about the purpose of writing letter. After this, you'll talk about purpose of writing letter. Why are you writing this letter? Because you want. Okay, just a minute. So why are you writing letter? Because you want to ask certain details from that manager. So mention this. I'm writing this letter to know certain details before taking admission in the academy. Or I want to learn dance, but before I join your academy, I would like to know a few things. And I'm very sure that your kind self, your esteemed self would definitely satisfy my doubts or my queries. Is that clear? So that is up till the first paragraph. Reference, introduction to yourself, and then purpose of writing letter. It's all first paragraph. Second paragraph is all about your main question, that is inquiry. In the second paragraph, mention, ask exactly the ask questions. But here, ask question doesn't mean that do you have good infrastructure? Do you have a trained faculty? Does your academy have enough parking facilities? Do you charge a reasonable fee from the clients? Not like this. Not like this. I've told you the questions, but you won't ask the questions like this. You'll be asking questions in a very formal and courteous manner. Same questions, but what will be the tone? What did I say right now? Gurpal will tell me. In a very courteous manner. Sit down. So how will we start? Here in the previous line, we have already told him, like, before I take admission in your esteemed institute, I would like to know of you. I would like to seek some details. And I'm very sure that I'll be satisfied. Yes, one thing more you add there also. Like, why will that manager, why will that academy answer your questions? Why will they read your paper, I mean letter? Why will they send you the reply? Because they want to? we want to join, but why will they answer us? Because they will get a new customer or a new client. Okay, so when they will, but how will they get a new client? When we tell them, like, I would like to join. So here in the previous paragraph, we'll have to make it very clear that I'm very sure that you will definitely reply my letter. And if I'll be satisfied with your terms and conditions, I'll take admission in your esteemed institute. Is that clear? I'm very keen to take admission in your institute, but provided I am satisfied with the details which I'll be asking you. And here also you can, Beta, when you talk one word with my one sentence each, you're not listening to me at all. You're losing a lot. Once you listen to this format, you will never ever need to read or know how to write a letter. One lecture will enable you to write 10,000 letters. Any kind of letter, I mean. So second paragraph, you exactly ask the question, but in a courteous manner. For example, first of all, the very first expression you'll be using it. First of all, I would like to know the timings your academy has for different batches. Or first of all, I would like to know whether your academy offers suitable timings for the evening batches. Because your very first requirement is that you'll be able to go there only in the evening because you are a student. And even if you are a businessman, you might say, like, if there is any scope for late evening batches, because the businessman would not be free before 8. Okay. So first of all, write down the expression, first of all. First of all, I would like to ask, or first of all, I would like to know if your academy offers suitable timing for the evening batches. Because I am a student and I would not be able to. Or because I'm a student, so the evening time would be most suitable to me. Right? Second point we'll discuss tomorrow, and this much you write the letter today. Yeah, fair.